We're going to draw a sphere. So file new. Label this sphere. Click web. Change this to inches. 11 inches wide. 8.5 high. Click the advanced option. Make sure it's RGB color. And 150 ppi. And create. Next, we're going to place the image, file, place, and I have the image on my desktop, sphere, JPEG, place. Position the cursor at the upper left-hand corner and click once. To check the positions of the place image, the upper left-hand reference point is selected, and the orientations or this corner is at 0, 0. The width of the image, 11 inches and 8.5 inches high. The image is now positioned perfectly. Go to the layer. Change this to photo. Always label your layers. And lock the layer by clicking here. And this locks it. Create a new layer. Label this sphere. Press L. That's going to instantly select the ellipse tool. Position the cursor at the corner of the sphere. Click and drag. Hold down the shift key. And make sure that this circle matches the image almost perfectly. And let go. Here it has a fill. So I want to switch the fill to stroke by clicking on this arrow. Now I can see the image underneath. I use the arrow key to nudge this close to the photo. Zoom in. Press spacebar so I can scroll. I'm going to grab the upper right-hand corner. Press the shift. So I can scale this down just a little bit to match the image. Press the arrow keys to nudge it. Press the space bar to move. Click the corner, press the shift, scale this to make sure that this matches the photo. That looks pretty good. Zoom out. I'm going to open this layer and then label this path sphere. By positioning the cursor around the corner of the shadow and drag it, just get it close. It's not going to match it perfectly because I need to rotate it. Press the R, that gives you the rotate tool. And I'm going to click and drag to rotate this ellipse, get it as close to the shadow as possible, and then using the arrow keys to nudge it. Press the V, and then that goes to the selection tool. And you can see that the box appear. And I'm going to grab the handle and get this close. Grab the handles on top, move it down to get this close to the image. Zoom in. Do some fine tuning. That looks pretty good. Now it looks really good. Zoom out, label this shadow. Drag this path below the sphere, put it in the proper order. So the next thing I'm gonna do is press the eye, that gives me the eyedropper tool, pick up this color from the photo. And then I'm going to go to the sphere, pick up a color, and you can see that the sphere needs a gradient. And then this is a solid color. So I'm going to change this from the solid color to gradient by coming to the here. And then you see that there's three little box. And then click the middle, gradient, click. And this will give you a linear gradient by default. And then also the gradient panel is going to open. This requires a radial gradient. This will allow you to choose from linear to radial. So click the radial gradient. And now put the cursor to the gradient tool. So, or you can press G, that will select the gradient tool. And then you see that this little bar shows up. Let's look at the gradient. The lightest part is right here. And then the darkest part is right here. This is almost like a 45 degree angle. And then this is the positions of the brightest part. So it's approximately right here. And then this is the positions of the shadow area. Position here, click and drag. Approximately 45 degree angle, similar to what you see here. And that's giving me the radial gradient. But we're gonna change the color. Come here, click, activate this color, and then choose the eyedropper tool from the gradient panel. Pick this color from the photo. Come down here and then click and activate the color in the shadow side. Make sure that the eyedropper is still selected. Click this color. It is still not matching the photo yet because there's a band of core, a darker values right from this area. So what you do is that you position the cursor approximately in the same area. When you move your cursor, you'll see that a plus sign shows up. So click and then you're gonna add a color right in that location. So while this is activated, using the color picker, I'm going to pick this color. And then right away, you see that now it's kind of matching what you see here. So the gradient is closely matching the photo. There are several things that you can do with the gradient. One is click on this, click and drag, and then you can see you can position the color. Another control is at the midpoint. You can click and drag the midpoint, and then also can affect the overall gradient. The midpoint, so I'm going to move the midpoint over just a little bit here, and then you can see the location indicated here. So this will allow you to put in a precise value. Let's say I want it to be at the 75% mark. I can move it really accurately. So there are a lot of really nice fine control that you can do to this image. And then right here, the gradients, I'm going to drag this gradient down a little bit. That kind of matches this a little bit closer. And so the gradient now is looking really close. However, it is not perfect yet, because if you look at this gradient, this core is darker here and then lighter on the bottom. I'm going to add another gradient to lighten the under part and then not affecting the top part. Go to the appearance panel, click the appearance, shows you the fill and then the stroke assigned to this pass. Now in order to see all of the, you need to press the escape. Once you press the escape, and you see that you will now have even more control that shows up. So move the cursor to here, to the upper right corner, add new fill. The new fill is going to be added exactly the same as the one that was selected before. So you're not going to see any different, but this is adding a new fill. Let's just turn off the fill on the bottom. Clicking on the eyes, you actually can, you see that you can turn it off completely. And you can turn off the stroke. And then let me just position the fill right above the old one. So, and then turn it on. So this is a fill that we just created. Now I'm going to change the fill to a linear fill by going to the gradient again, selecting the gradient panel again, and then switch this back to linear. Make sure that this is at the gradient tool. I'm going to click and drag. We can press on the shift keys to maintain this complete vertical orientation. The first color, the color on top, this color, so let me just activate this. This color, I'm going to change this to white. Double click on this. Change this to grayscale. And I'm going to change this to complete white. The opacity, I want to change it to zero opacity. Okay, so now you see that there's nothing, opacity. I don't need the middle color, so I'm going to click and drag this out. So I eliminate that color altogether. So now I have the second color down here. Click this, activate this, double click, change this to grayscale, to white, and then the opacity right now is 100%. So what this does is that now I have 100% white here, gradate to 0% white on top. I want to brighten the bottom, but not touching anything on top. So go back to the appearance panel. So by clicking on the appearance, and then this was the fill that was created. Press escape again. It's important to press escape so you reveal all the other fills. And I'm going to turn on the fill that was there before. And then so this was the fill before, the radial fill. And then this is the new fill created to brighten only the bottom part. So now I can do some adjustment. This is still way too strong because it brightened the bottom part way too much. So I'm going to change the opacity. Click here. The opacity, I can drag this and then little at a time to make fine-tune adjustments so then the brightening matches what you see here. That's a little bit still too strong. Maybe 30% will be good. So let's go to 30%. Press the tab to see, to commit. Okay, that looks pretty good. I'm going to stay with this. And there you go. Using two fill to get this image to match the photo. Now I'm going to lock the sphere, and I'm going to work on the shadow side. Activate the shadow. The shadow also requires a radial fill. Click on the gradient. This was the gradient that was used. I need to have a radial gradient, so I'm going to click on the radial gradient. Click radial gradient. Press G to give me the gradient tool. I'm going to position the gradient tool down here, drag it all the way to here, going from the darkest to the lightest part of the gradient. This is the direction. Now I'm going to change the color. Activate this color, press the eyedropper tool, click here, click on this value using the eyedropper tool, click here, and that gives me the image. Put the cursor here, and then move the gradient bar around. To give me the precise look. So here, let me just activate this one more time, and then pick a slightly lighter value. So this is the way to create a photorealistic sphere. The next thing I'm going to talk about is adding colors. Unlock the sphere. turn it on, Appearance, Panel, add a new fill, change the fill to a color. Double click here, select red, say OK, switch this to RGB, back to the appearance. I'm going to click on the opacity. This opens up this panel. Here are the blend modes. So click here. Normal is a solid red. If I change this to darken, and you can see what it does, changes to multiply, changes to color burn. So you can try these functions to see what kind of effect it has on the image. Overlay, that looks really good. Now the red is a little bit strong. I can change this to a little bit lighter values by changing the opacity if I want to get it to match. So there you go, a photorealistic sphere.